係召開沙中線的會議，特別會議又好，或者是事務委員會會議又好，或者是鐵路小組的委員會都好，是要盡快召開的。但是一路呢拖到現在呢都未有會議安排到。我剛才呢就是親自再問一次鐵路事宜小組的主席田北辰，問下他安排幾時召開會議，如果不安排會議原因是甚麼。他呢的答覆呢就是說呢他是要尋求政府和港鐵的同意才可以安排這個會議，就說呢政府和港鐵呢是未答應是何時出席會議，所以個會議就到現在都未開得成了。我想我的質問就是說，當立法會要就著公眾關注的鐵路安全工程質量監管問題有重大關注的時候，議員要求召開會議是必須要的，那官員出不出席和港鐵出不出席呢，他們都是有應有之義，是他們的出席會議的責任來的，就沒可能調回轉頭呢鐵路事宜小組的主席或者交通事務委員會的主席要等到政府同意出席才可以安排會議。那所以其實開不開會就是議員的決定，官員就必須要出席，涉事的有關的機構亦都要派人出席，派誰出席是他們的決定，但是就不可以說我不答你啊，不覆你啊，不來啊，那你就浪起了立法會沒得談。那所以呢我覺得呢對這件事的安排呢我是表示呢嚴重的抗議的。
在昨天港鐵召開記者會交代土瓜灣站的問題時候呢，他是披露了有關的承建商是拒絕去跟港鐵會面的。我即難以想像港鐵是會拒絕出席立法會鐵路事宜小組或者是交通事務委員會啦。而我們現在獲得田北辰主席的訊息，就說要等港鐵和政府同意才決定召不召開。我覺得我們立法會是應該有自己的決定權去召不召開會議，如果他們是拒絕出席會議的話，他們需要跟公眾有一個交代。另一方面，剛才陳帆局長在口頭質詢答的問題不斷就在那裡說他對港鐵的監管失望諸如此類，但是不要忘記港鐵的董事局有四名官方成員，包括財經及庫務局局長劉怡翔、運房局局長陳帆、運輸署署長陳美寶小姐，還有發展局常任秘書長在個董事局入面。所以陳帆局長絕對不可以一路在度批評港鐵怎樣危機處理不足啊，後知後覺啊，他自己是港鐵董事局的當然成員來的，他可不可以置身事外呢？他一班官員四個人坐在港鐵董事局裡面是發夢的嗎？這麼久以來這麼多事故，你後知後覺你都要做好個危機處理啊，但是你發揮到什麼角色，發揮到什麼功效呢？是不是一味在那裡等港鐵就等禮頓報告，路政署就等港鐵報告，運房局就等路政署報告，層層地去卸責推裝呢？即我對於陳帆局長一種過去我批評我是佛系管理啦，我現在呢是認為他根本是全心和港鐵的責任劃清界線，這個是絕對不能夠接受的，亦都不是所謂政治問責官員應有的問責態度。
我都補充一點呢，就是剛才在立法會入面的口頭問題呢，你見到陳帆局長的回答呢，是見到呢路政署一路睇緊的所謂監管呢，重點是講緊工程的進度同埋有冇超支。咁事實上今次出事的呢就不是講緊進度和超支的問題，而是工程質量的問題，有沒有按設計圖施工， 在施工過程裏面出現問題的時候，那個監管是怎樣？咁你見到咧，政府就話我哋係路政署有人同港鐵開會㗎咁。咁如果淨係將監管咧理解成為咧去開會咧，咁就大鑊啦。唔怪之會咁多問題啦。咁其實咧個問題，你見到鐵路嘅監管咧，同水係一樣嘅就係鉛水，因為鉛水都係話水務署有監管㗎，房屋署有監管㗎，點解全部有監管，最後會出事咧？咁你根本上就見到呢啲監管咧，如果只係坐喺個房度開會，資料又不齊全，又有人刻意隱瞞，好多嘢又唔呈報嘅時候，政府監管嘅人員如果冇落地盤睇，你淨係同港鐵傾有咩用呢？港鐵前線人員又唔話俾港鐵高層聽，然後總承建商禮頓又唔話俾港鐵聽，跟住分判商出事又冇話俾總承建商聽，試圖有人想呈報啲嘢上去嘅時候又冇人理。咁所以成個問題呢，就係叫做監管系統形同虛設。咁所以個問題係非常之嚴重嘅。咁嘅情況底下，如果鐵路事宜小組仲唔開會，如果交通事務委員會仲唔開會，而官員同埋港鐵仲拒絕出席嘅話呢，這個呢我哋係覺得呢絕對不可以接受嘅。咁我覺得兩位主席係應該盡快出嚟係安排會議。咁而官員係冇得唔出席會議嘅，因為咧行政機關向立法機關交代問責咧，係憲法上邊要求佢哋咁做嘅。咁所以民主黨希望咧，田北辰主席同埋易志明主席咧，係盡快安排呢一個會議，係等議員係可以清楚去就住事件係作出詳細嘅討論同埋質詢。大家見到入邊就住呢個議題講廿二分鐘，有好多議員撳乜掣都冇得問噶嘛。咁如果大家認為立法會嘅角色就係咁樣樣啊，得幾個議員問，每人問一分鐘兩分鐘，咁其實根本上係冇可能監管到呢一個政府同埋鐵路嘅安全嘅。The reply from Michael Tin is that.He need government and MTR to agree with attending the meeting, and then the response is pending now. I think whether we want to hold a meeting to investigate the Sha Tin Central Link is subject to the decision of LegCo member, but not the agreement from the government or MTR. So I think we need to hold the meeting as soon as possible so thatthe executive, the government, as well as MPR, can respond to our questions.
I do think Chen Fan, Fan Chen, want to shift his responsibility as the.Secretary for Transport. As we know, the Secretary for Transport and the other government officials are the directors of the MTR. They should have borne the responsibility to oversee the operation of the MTR. However, there were so many scandals.Happen and discovered by the media, and I don't see the government officials play a proactive role to perform their duty. So I urge Fan Chen to take up the political responsibility.
What sort of progress do you think that you know the?
Based on the reply we just heard from Frank Chen, I think the government focus mainly on the progress of the construction and the expenses of the construction. But in terms of the regulation concerning the quality and safety.Of the entire construction. It seems that the government overlooked the issues, and on paper, they are quite comprehensive monitoring system. But if the government only do a armchair management, just hold meetings with MTR's top management, but not going into different layer and go to the field to check whether they comply with the contract requirement, then there are a lot of loopholes. And I think we need to have a comprehensive review on the existing regulatory regime to ensure that such mistakes will not happen again.
It seems that the government not only contract out the Sha-Tin Central Link project, but also try to contract out the political responsibility as the government to oversee the project. OK，我又翻去準備嗰個第四條。